Hi, I'm Tim Berglund with Confluent. I'd like to show you KSQL, the open source streaming SQL engine for Apache Kafka. It's an easy to use yet powerful technology that lets you define continuous, interactive SQL queries against data in Kafka. And like Kafka, KSQL is elastically scalable, fault-tolerant, distributed, does all the work in real time, and it works for you regardless of what programming language you use in the rest of your stack. Let me show you what it can do. First, let me get Kafka running locally. Next up, we'll need some test data to play with. This script is generating some fake clickstream data and writing it to a Kafka topic. Now, in KSQL, I'll need to create a stream representing the data in that topic. Notice how I named that topic in the stream definition, that's clickstream, and also defined the stream schema. Let's focus on the user ID field for a moment. If we look at the data in that stream, which we can do with a select statement, user ID isn't all that easy to understand. And another thing, notice the select just keeps running until we stop it. That's because this select is a streaming query, so the select is never done. As long as messages keep arriving in the source topic that we're selecting on, the select will always have more results for us. It runs until we stop it. Now, I'd like to translate those cumbersome user IDs into proper usernames. This is an example of data enrichment using joins. Here, I want to join our original stream with information from a user table. To make this happen, I'm going to need to generate a table with some simulated user profiles in it. You could see that our test data has usernames and proper names and locations, and of course, there's the user ID field. All of this is being dumped into a Kafka topic. In KSQL, we're going to interpret that topic as a table. Now, this may seem like a strange thing to say, but just think of the messages in the topic as updates to rows in a table, or like they were entries in a change log being generated from that table. For example, having a new message show up in the topic would indicate that a user had changed maybe their location to a different city. Now, we're all set up to join our stream of click events to the users table with one line of KSQL. The syntax of the join statement probably looks awfully familiar. This stuff is not hard to learn. Now let's have a look at the joined stream. We have usernames now instead of those bare IDs. And once again, the results just keep coming in since new simulated clicks are happening all the time. And this joined output stream is being continuously written to a Kafka topic. And any Kafka consumer, Kafka Connect, Kafka Streams applications, or other KSQL queries, any consumer can access that topic, just like normal, whenever they'd like. Now that our data is enriched, let's get going with some analysis. Here, I'm aggregating the clickstream data to make a table of malicious users, which we'll define as any individual IP address that requests more than 50 kilobytes of web resources during a 300-second session window. We'll display the data in kilobytes here, just for convenience. We can select from that table to see who the malicious users are, but this is still a little hard to take in at a glance. So let's use Kafka Connect to load our enriched clickstream data into Elasticsearch, which we can then visualize with Grafana. And there it is. Each dot is a session belonging to a particular user. The x-axis is time, and the y-axis is traffic in kilobytes. The legend below maps the colors onto particular usernames and IP addresses. Notice how they're all increasing in traffic, the terrible malicious users that they are. But there's even more analysis we need to do, which will require some more KSQL. I'm going to run all those queries from a script to save us some time. I'll also let Kafka Connect know about the new streams and tables we've created, and of course their underlying topics, so Grafana can see them. Now we see a much richer dashboard. At upper right, there's the list of the malicious users, including joined IP address and username. At upper left, we have a display of time-binned HTTP error codes occurring on the site. That's a whole new thing. Down below, we've got a sessionized view of user traffic. There's a min-max average analysis of resource requests across all users. And there's another roll-up of HTTP errors built from the joined clickstream data. There's a lot in here. And it was created in its entirety from KSQL queries and Kafka Connect. I encourage you to take a look at this demo code, and whatever you do, definitely take a look at KSQL. It's the indispensable tool for processing streaming data in Kafka.